Last time we talked about Bohmian mechanics, a possible alternative to quantum mechanics. One of the appeals of Bohmian mechanics is that we can always, at any time, say that this is the position of our particle. On the other hand, with quantum mechanics, the superposition principle forces us to say things like, the particle is in many different states at the same time. With Bohmian mechanics, it's as though reality properly exists, regardless of whether we're measuring it or not. Or does it? Today we're going to look at a potentially big problem with Bohmian mechanics. The issue is something called contextuality. Let me explain it. With any sensible theory, you want measurement to reveal a property that the particle already had, not create or change it. I should point out that under this condition, quantum mechanics is clearly not sensible. But from what we saw last time, it seems like Bohmian mechanics is. So if you measure, say, the spin of a particle in the y direction, and you find it to be spin up, in Bohmian mechanics, you want to be able to say then that the particle had spin up beforehand. But what about the case where there's more than one way to measure the spin of a particle? Another sensible sensibility criteria is that different ways to measure something should agree, so both those measurements should give the same answer. We'll call this non-contextuality, because the result of the measurement shouldn't depend on the experimental context. This is where the problem is, though. In Bohmian mechanics, this doesn't always happen. So instead of always being able to say statements like, this particle has spin up in the y direction, you're instead reduced to saying things like, this particle has spin up in the y direction if you measure it this way, but spin down if you measure it another way. It's still perfectly deterministic, there's no randomness, but it's just not that nice. This is what we call contextuality. Let me show you an example of this happening. This example is going to be about the spin of an electron. Don't panic if you've forgotten all about spin. I'm only going to use some very basic facts about it. If you want a refresher on spin, though, you can go watch this video about it. First, remember that every electron has its spin pointing in one particular direction. However, it's also possible to measure the spin of an electron in any direction, and this is where it gets weird. Whatever direction you pick, there are only two possible values you can get, which we call spin up and spin down, for reasons that you'll see soon. If you're feeling uncomfortable about spin at this point, feel free to watch that video and ask me questions. Back to spin though. There's a pretty standard way to measure the spin of a particle. It's called the Stern-Gerlach machine. You set it up to measure spin along a certain axis, let's say the y-axis. Then what happens is electrons go through this passage. I won't go into how this works, but if your particle happened to be one that already had spin up in the y-axis, it will get deflected up and get measured around here. If your particle started with spin down in the y-axis, then it will get deflected down. How does Bohmian mechanics explain this? Remember that in Bohmian mechanics, there is a quantum force that depends on the wave function. Well, spin is one of the things that influence the wave function, so the quantum force takes spin into account, and then pushes the electron in the correct directions to get these cases. Of course, most electrons have their spin in other directions. What about if a bunch of electrons happen to have their spin in the x direction, which is perpendicular to y? As we saw in the spin video, when you measure these particles in the y direction, half of them will have spin up and half of them will have spin down. Again, Bohmian mechanics needs to explain this. First, we need to deal with something. There is no real randomness in Bohmian mechanics, only randomness from ignorance. So we need to be able to explain why half the particles go one way and half the other. This is how it's done. Let's say all the electrons start off somewhere inside this little sphere, but we don't know exactly where inside. If one of these particles starts off in the top half, you can calculate by Bohmian mechanics that it will deflect up, and similarly for the bottom half, giving exactly the right result. No issues so far. Now let's look at sensibility condition number one again. We measure that this particle starts here and has spin up in the y direction, So our condition tells us that it must have had spin up in that direction all along. Again, this seems fairly innocuous. The problem is that there's another way to measure the spin of that particular particle. Why not set the Stern-Gerlach machine to measure spin in the negative y direction instead? What should happen? Well, we've already decided that this particle has spin up in the y direction, so by the properties of spin, it must have spin down in the negative direction. Sorry, that's the last fact that I'll use from that spin video. So that means that our particle has spin down in the negative y direction, so it's deflected down now, right? Nup, that's not what Bohmian mechanics says. It still goes up, which forces us to conclude that it has spin down in the y direction. And now we see how our second sensibility condition is broken. If we measure the first way, our particle will look like it had spin up, but if we measure the second way, it will look like it had spin down. Notice that I'm not saying Bohmian mechanics makes the wrong experimental prediction, because in the second case, we also expect that half the electrons deflect up and half deflect down, and that's exactly what happens. Bohmian mechanics can give you the right predictions on any Stern-Gerlach experiment. The issue is much more subtle than that. If we can't say our particle has property X without adding the proviso, so long as you measure it this way, then what property does the particle have before anyone decides how to measure it? I mean, this seems like a quantum mechanics level philosophical problem. So, should we scrap Bohmian mechanics and look for some other, better alternative to quantum? Not so fast. In fact, it's possible to prove that for any theory that has sensibility condition number one, that experiments reveal pre-existing properties, then our second condition, that properties don't depend on the type of experiment, will always be broken. At least whenever you're talking about spin. In other words, there are no completely sensible theories. There's a lot of hype about this contextuality, but I'm not sure how seriously we should take it. You see, this issue doesn't come up at all when we're talking about most variables in Bohmian mechanics, like position, momentum, and energy. It's perfectly legitimate to say that this particle has this position, regardless of how you measure it. The problem only comes when you try and say statements like that about spin and other similar variables. That's why some people say the theory isn't broken, only the way we think about spin is. They say spin is not a real property of a particle like position and momentum. Instead, it only comes into play in an indirect way. The spin affects the wave function, which affects the quantum force, which changes the direction of the particle. It doesn't make sense to say a particle has spin up. Instead, what you mean is the particle experiences some extra quantum force upwards because of spin. I'm pretty conflicted about this, and I'd love to hear your opinion about all of this. Does Bohmian mechanics escape, or is this really the final blow for all sensible alternatives to quantum mechanics? I don't know, but I'd like to leave you with one deep and meaningful thought though. Spin is weird.